Hey folks, it's Jared Manninen from the website TahoeTrailGuide.com. Today I'm going to be discussing briefly the reasons why I will not be integrating into my quiver of backcountry cross-country skis the new or newer Rottefella Xplore binding system. This is a question that's been coming up and being asked of me over the last, 2 years that Xplore has been out. And it's not that I don't have anything against it, it's just I've essentially invested so much in the NNN BC binding system, as well as just a basic 3-pin without cable binding system as well. And although I really appreciate the innovation that comes with the new Xplore system, I have a friend who has it who really likes it. I just really like the NNN BC system particularly, and the 3-pin basic, you know, Rottefella Super Tele binding, which is just a bail clamp 3-pin system. I really like both of those, more the NNN BC, because a lot of what I do I would consider almost a little bit more backcountry cross-country or backcountry Nordic skiing, as opposed to XED cross-country downhill with a lot of emphasis on the downhill, or alpine touring, for example. I obviously don't do that because I don't have any of those skis, but mostly I prefer to stay on lower angle terrain. And again, that NNN BC binding for the most part is good enough, but I honestly just don't feel compelled to invest a whole bunch into a new system. I have so many boots for NNN BC, and I have a handful of boots of 3-pin compatibility, and then I have so many skis that have the NNN BC. I only have a couple with the 3-pin binding, but I just don't want to spend more money on a new system. And if you know anything about the outdoor recreation industry when it comes to gear, a lot of manufacturers just stop production on certain things. So although I absolutely love gear, I suffer from gear lust as much as any other outdoors person. I have tons of gear. I end up finding stuff that I really love, and then I just buy multiple copies of it. Even these ridiculous gloves that I wear. It's a mountain biking glove that doesn't have a gauntlet, so I can read my watch a lot easier than stuff that goes over the wrist. And I just love these particular. I love the zaniness of the design. So I bought like 12 of these or 15 over the last couple of years. I get them on clearance sale, the ones that they don't sell real well or whatever during a full price regular season. But these are all limited. I'll never find this particular pattern of glove again. I even found out because I wasn't even paying attention really, but Fischer isn't making the Excursion 88s or the S-Bound 112s anymore. You have to buy what is left in stores around small shops across America, and good luck trying to find them online. There's like nobody selling in them. Fortunately, in town, I had a shop that still had some S-Bound 112s, and I got it at 30% off, which was like bonus. But I just bought a backup ski in case I can't ever find them again. So I love gear, I love buying gear, I love owning gear, but I usually love owning the stuff that I love, not necessarily the newest stuff that comes out on the market. I just don't get new stuff. So I'm kind of sticking with what I have. It's doing me well. I don't feel any need to swap out to a new binding system. So that's the long answer to the short question. No, I'm not getting the Xplore binding. I have nothing against it. I think it looks really cool, looks really fun, but it also, to me, looks more geared towards downhill. And again, I like doing striding, diagonal striding, classic technique whenever possible. And that NNN BC is a natural transition from standard NNN with classic track skis. So it runs well in most conditions. So yeah, I'm sorry to report that I don't have any insight about the Xplore system. I mounted one set for my friend, and it was kind of a nightmare because there's no jig. Like, the NNN platform has a jig that I use that's very easy, lines up the holes, boom, and no sweat. But I had to do some creative math and problem solving to get everything lined up, and I hate doing that without having a jig. I just get so nervous about putting holes in skis, so. Yeah, I don't want to mount them, and there's no jig for that yet, so it's like just another reason for me not to buy them. But from what I hear, great system, very stable going downhill. Anyway, gear lust only goes so far in my book, so that's that. If you have any feedback about the system and really think I should invest, feel free to put a comment down below. don't be surprised if I say thank you and no thanks, but yeah, I don't want to spend any more money on new stuff. Leave comments, feedback, like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, check out TahoeTrailGuide.com. Thank you to all my Patreon subscribers, those who leave tips and gratuities via PayPal and Venmo. You guys are amazing. I appreciate all you guys do in support of this channel and me. It's a super fun thing to be able to provide this kind of information and stories and inspiration to you guys. So take care, everyone.